Transient dizziness or vertigo that occurs with head movements is often attributed to a vestibular problem like BPPV. However, cervical spine problems that have nothing to do with the inner ear can also elicit vertigo attacks with head movements. Additional symptoms that suggest a cervicogenic source of dizziness instead of the inner ear include history of headache, neck pain, and limited cervical range of motion. There are three bedside tests that can further suggest the diagnosis of cervicogenic vertigo, especially if the Dix-Hallpike test for BPPV comes back normal. For all three tests, the head is kept still to prevent any activation of the inner ear balance system. As such, any test movements that trigger dizziness is thus isolated to the cervical spine as the source of the vertigo. The first test is called the cervical torsion test. The cervical torsion test is performed with the patient seated on a swivel chair with the hip and knees flexed to 90 degrees. The patient closes both eyes and the examiner fixates the patient's head in neutral position as shown. The patient is then asked to actively rotate the body 45 to 90 degrees to one side and hold for 30 seconds. When returned to neutral position, the patient may open the eyes. The test is then repeated in the opposite direction, again with the eyes first closed. The test is positive if the patient reports any dizziness and/or any other symptoms other than normal. Other symptoms include visual disturbances, speech disturbances, motion sickness, nausea, trouble swallowing, lightheadedness, tinnitus, headache, and/or paresthesias during or immediately after the test. The head-neck differentiation test is similar to the cervical torsion test. The head-neck differentiation test is performed with the patient seated on a swivel chair with the hip and knees flexed to 90 degrees. The patient closes both eyes and the examiner fixates the patient's head in neutral position as shown. The patient is then asked to actively rotate the body 45 degrees with the help of the legs to the left and then right side in an alternating fashion at a metronome pace of 60 beats per minute for at least 30 seconds. The test is positive if the patient reports any dizziness and/or any other symptoms other than normal. Other symptoms include visual disturbances, speech disturbances, motion sickness, nausea, trouble swallowing, lightheadedness, tinnitus, headache, and/or paresthesias during or immediately after the test. The final test for cervicogenic vertigo is smooth pursuit neck torsion test. The smooth pursuit neck torsion test is performed by first having the patient sitting on a swivel chair. While the patient's head is kept still in a neutral position, the patient is to track the examiner's finger, which is moved slowly side to side in a horizontal direction. While keeping the head still, the test is then repeated with the body rotated 45 degrees to one side. And then repeated again with the body rotated 45 degrees to the opposite side. The test is positive if dizziness is triggered in the rotation position compared to neutral. If cervicogenic vertigo is suspected, please see your healthcare professional for further treatment guidance. A neurologist or a spine specialist are the doctors who specialize in treating this condition. There are also home exercises that can be performed to treat cervicogenic vertigo, but should only be performed if there is no pain and no numbness present. See the description box for other bedside tests to evaluate for vertigo.